This tutorial will show how to create a student collection folder so that the student can turn in items to their teacher through a shared Google Drive environment and still retain ownership of those items. And the teacher can access the work that the students are working on or are turning in for credit without being notified by email every single time an item comes in. So to begin, we're going to go to the student side. And we're going to have the student create a folder with which they're going to share with their teacher. So in Drive, they're going to click the Create button and create a folder. The name of the folder is important. You want to make sure that you're clear with your students what kind of naming scheme you'd like them to use. I recommend a naming scheme that makes the folder easily identifiable both to the student and to the teacher. In this case, having the student put their username in, followed by the teacher's name. So the username of the student will clearly identify the folder for the teacher, and the teacher's name will let the student know which teacher's folder this is shared with. So we're going to click Create. And so now we have a folder to share with Mr. Schumann. So I need to now share that. So I'm going to select that folder and click the Share button and share this with my teacher. I want to make sure that I have can edit as the permission so that my teacher can not only view the items that are turned into this shared folder, but that the teacher can comment and make suggestions and give feedback to this, the items I turn in. And then I'm going to hit send. So on the student side, the folder will now have a small figure printed on it to let the student know that this folder is shared. On the teacher side, the teacher is going to go to the Shared with Me section. And they will locate all of the folders that their students have shared with them. I'm going to select those folders and choose to add them to my drive for easy access. And I'm going to come back to my drive and finally select those folders one more time and move them so that I have them in one place based on the class. In this case, it's a Science Block 2 green. So I'm going to drag and add them to that folder. So now, as the teacher, anytime I want to check to see if students have turned work into me, I just go to this folder, and all of the student folders will be listed here. Bolded folders mean there's items in there that haven't been viewed by me yet, the teacher. I can also use the Activity Stream tool, located over here, and get a quick summary of all of the activity that is going on inside this class folder from day to day, week to week. For example, I'm going to go back to the student screen, and I have this Chapter 2 reflection that I need to turn in for credit to my teacher. So I'm going to take that folder, rather file, and I'm going to move it into the shared folder with my teacher. I can click and drag it in, or I can use the Move To option and give it to my teacher. Now the student still owns the file. It's in the folder here. They still own it. They can access it and they can make changes to it. But now the teacher can go into the same location, find the file, and open it, and make comments, help with editing, give constructive feedback. So, first, you have the student create a folder to share with their teacher, making sure that the student follows the naming scheme that you, the teacher, establish, and that they give you, the teacher, edit permissions over that folder. On the teacher side, you would go to the Shared With Me section, select those folders, and add them to My Drive. Once they're in My Drive, you would add them to a folder representing that particular class, so that you can go into that folder, view all the folders for all the students in that class, and access the contents within. You can also use Activity Stream to get a summary of all the activity that's been going on within this group of students. This concludes this tutorial.